Hello everyone, this is Tesnotsu, and welcome to my third video of Colonel Sanders Finger Licking Good Dating Simulator. And yes, he was speaking softly, so let's see what he says. Those mashed potatoes you made in class today. Before you go on, I want you to know they're not a great representation of my skills. I didn't even realize I was making them. They were amazing. Tasting them, it reminded me why I became so passionate about food to begin with. Colonel Sanders is getting choked up. Cooking is obviously important to him in a way that you find inspiring. Now might be the perfect time to tell him you're developing feelings for him. Colonel Sanders?
Yes, Sanatsu.
There's something I need to tell you. Hold it right there! There's something I need to tell you first! Oh, jeez. You see, when I was just a boy, I had a dream that one day I would be the greatest chef the world has ever seen. And every day since, I have been working towards that dream, day and night, never stopping, never resting, also lifting a lot of weights, like so many weights. We should follow our dreams with all of our hearts, that's our souls may grant them like wishes floating on a shooting star. Hey, no, yo. Shut up! I'm the one here to say inspirational stuff and be the star of the story!
Are we forgetting that your cooking literally killed a guy?
You can't prove that!
I also saw you kill that guy. What was his name?
Somewhere in the distance you hear a long, sad sigh.
Forget him. We are talking about me, 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 me. I am the hero.
Sure, Van. Sure, you are the hero. But just go, please.
This pork monster is here to fight a hero.
I think I left the fridge door open. Later, nerds.
How dare you threaten me just as I was letting down my guard and connecting with another chef on an emotional level.
Be afraid! Be very afraid of me because I'm a monster. See?
Is his rhyming on purpose or is it that just a coincidence? But before we can discuss syntax any further,
it's a turn-based fight sequence!
What will you do?
Attack!
You decide to go on the attack. Which attack will you use? Cook with love? Cook with love does one damage!
It just got real.
That attack really upsets Spork Monster. Spork Monster goes on the attack. They spit hot gravy at you. You take one damage. I think maybe I should defend this time. Maybe. You decide to defend. Which defense will you use? Trepidation. You continue to stay back and enter whatever comes your way. Seems like a pretty weird strategy, but okay, sure, you do you. I'm doing my best here. What do you want from me, game? Spork Monster focuses their massed mind and draws in energy from Mother Earth itself. They grow larger and more intimidating. How will you respond? Oh shit, I guess I'll defend. You decide to defend. Which defense will you use? Poof poof. You drop energy into your arms, thinking back and on all of that stirring you did in the kitchen as a child. Your muscles go super swole, and you're ready to take on anything.
Sporkmonster is now quitter, poofed up and ready to rumble. They go on the attack once again. Sporkmonster uses utilitensile. You take 2 damage from the attack. If you take much more damage, you're not going to survive the battle. Ah, shit. Defend. You decide to defend. Which defense will you use? Puff up. No one can control this much puffness. You start to feel bloated and, quite frankly, a little gassy. Oh, I should just fart on this monster. That's what I should do. You'd better attack soon or you're likely to explode. You decide to go on the attack. Cook with love. Nah, that doesn't do anything. Show down. Rowdy Russet Roundhouse. I'm gonna use this one. This sounds cool. Light beams out of your eyes. You have transformed into a being of pure flavor. You spin so quickly that your movements become nearly invisible as you lash out at the Spork Monster. Rowdy Russet Roundhouse does 8 damage. Spork Monster is oozing cheese sauce onto the lawn on the quad. I wonder who is going to have to clean that up. Not me. I'm not going to clean that. Feeling vulnerable, Spork Monster prepares for its ultimate attack. Rounded edge. Vile villain! Your reign of terror stops here. Colonel Sanders summons the energy of 1,000 chickens. Bot by Power Pinch! Bot by Power Pinch does 10 damage. Spork Monster is defeated. You saved me! An injured Spork Monster spews steam into the night. Forget mercy, finish him! Spare this wretched beast! Okay. This is not. Was it Tekken? No, this is not Tekken. So,
yeah,
you manage to damp down your disgust at the sight of this gnarly beast long enough to realize that he is still a living creature with a poor soul who deserves your pity, not your wrath. Begone, beast, and don't you dare come back for a follow-up encounter tomorrow.
I won't forget this, and I certainly won't be back like you said.
The Spork Monster scuttles off into the night. Somehow that I felt like that was too much to my voice. The defeated monster left behind a special item. It appears at first to be a cookbook, but upon closer inspection, it's so much more. It's a book of magic spells with a golden chicken on the cover. You open the cover and find the library card tucked inside. The last name to have signed it out is Porco.
Porco. That name sounds strangely familiar.
Your blood is pumping as you stand in the quiet of the night holding the mysterious book in your hands. As you come down from your battle boss, you realize that your final attack has left you completely depleted. The world around you begins to fade away. Without any energy to keep your eyes open, darkness overtakes you. The image of Colonel Sanders flashes before your eyes as you fall asleep. He must have helped you to get home. In your tired state, you don't know if you could have made it without him. What a guy. Not creepy at all. Was it a mistake to have a crush on him? Oh shit. You want to thank him, but you don't have the strength to utter a single word. You feel your covers being pulled up over you as you are tucked in tightly. Good night, my colonel. In your dream, you're together with Colonel Sanders. For some reason, Sprinkles is also there, instructing your love. Dreams are weird. Yeah, dreams really are weird. Oh gosh. You awake on day 2 and attempt to process the wild visions you had. Were they memories or premonitions?
And then there was the secret ingredient that Connor Sanders went ahead and told you outright. Not much of a secret, huh? It's probably just because he already trusts you so much. Sure, that makes sense. We'll go with that. You meet up with your bestie in front of the school. Before you can tell her about the encounter with the sport monster, she launches into a story of her own.
Okay, I know this might sound a little strange, but I think I might be,
I think I might like Clank. Like him, like?
I know it sounds like it's moving too fast, but there's something about him. I like him, like him. We got to talking after class and he's actually a totally sweet guy. Not only that, but he's really smart. He told me all kinds of stories about Colonel Sanders. Did you know that Colonel Sanders was the most popular kid in his high school?
No, but that does make complete sense.
Yeah, but he was so popular that he was voted prom king at a school he didn't even go to, and was also the convertible that he himself rode in at the front of the homecoming parade.
I'm thinking maybe something got lost in pressure cooker language translationator. Either way, maybe it'd be best if you took it slow with this new boy, like I am with Colonel Sanders.
You and Colonel Sanders, the coolest guy in school, the most famous student to ever attend University of Cooking School, Academy for Learning, you're a thing now.
We definitely connected yesterday.
You're great. Why wouldn't he be into you, I guess?
Oh, I see. I see how it is. Miriam, please. We've been friends for years. Why do you turn like this for over one day? How dare you? Laughing at the implication that you and Colonel Sanders might be a thing is definitely not cool. You are great. Yes. I am great. Don't you say otherwise. You don't know me. I'm very great. Yeah, let's go. You have an idea about how to prove that your love is real. Well, if he's not into me, why did he tell me one of his secret ingredients? Your bestie's eyes light up.
A secret ingredient?
Yeah, I just say that a secret ingredient. Is there a dramatic echo in here? Miriam checks to make sure you're alone before continuing.
So this summer, when I was on vacation with my family, a lovely man approached me in the botanical garden where I was wandering.
This can't be good.
He told me all about his passion for spices, secret spices. The man even gave me some to show me what he meant. He said it was a powder created from super duper rare dried flower petals, and that if I did him a big favor, I could have some of my own.
Please, Miriam, don't tell me.
So I filled my suitcase with them and brought them home. He was so nice, he even met me at the gate when I arrived. Later when I cooked with them, a very strange feeling came over me and the flavor was unlike anything I'd ever tasted.
I think you're being very liberal with the meaning of spices here.
Whatever. Anyhow, we both share an interest in cooking, so we've stayed in touch. You know, like pimples. I bet he would love to know more about new spices.
Well, I'm definitely not supposed to share Colonel Sanders' secret recipe, and besides, I only know the one ingredient, so I doubt it will be much use to anyone.
Please, 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 it would mean the world to me. No one has to know it came from you or from Colonel Sanders.
What do you think? Should you protect Colonel Sanders' secret or share it with your bestie? Okay, so here's the thing. If he really gave me the real deal, which obviously is not salt, ahem. I don't know. Make up a fake ingredient, obviously. He's my boo. Don't you hurt him. Don't hurt my man. You quickly think of a fake ingredient name. I don't know. How about... It was Eye of Newt. I know, sounds like some kind of witch's potion, but what can you do? Eye of Newt? Wow! Her eyes light up imagining such a thing, and you figure that you've satisfied her curiosity and she'll move on. However, she immediately turns around and does some thumb typing on her phone that you can't quite see. That's probably not good. Yeah, and if I'm lucky, that was the secret ingredient. One of the other ingredients, I mean. And I'm screwed. Before you can ask her to confirm what she was definitely not texting secrets to other people, you are interrupted. A wind rushes in, cherry blossom petals fill the air. It's Colonel Sanders. He's arriving at school. Run to him. Stand back and admire his majestic glory. I would like to run, but he is on top of a horse. Horses can get easily scared, and if this is like if the developer of this game has taken that to account, that freaking horse is going to kick me in the nuts. I mean, what nuts? I don't have nuts, so. Colonel Sanders' horse is truly a thing of beauty. Without ever acknowledging that he's been watched, he does a short horse dance before dismounting with a flourish. He then slaps the beautiful creature gently on its rear, sending it running free into the countryside. You are so struck by the sight of him that you lose the ability to speak coherently.
Oh, I didn't realize anyone was watching. Don't worry. He knows his way home.
You attempt to compliment Colonel Sanders, but the words don't come out exactly right. What a horseful beard you have! I mean, what a horseful beard you have! Dang it, that's what I just said! Being a good friend, Miriam attempts to cover for you. Oh, Snatcher just gets really nervous around people they like. What? This is not helping. I mean, take up food poisoning and wear up all night. It was gruesome. You should have seen it. She gives you a wink and a smile as if to say, situation handled. Can't blame a girl for trying. And with that, Colonel Sanders disappears into the school, leaving you and Miriam to follow. Well, here's the thing. He knows what happened last night and she does not, so maybe he was like, what a weirdo. What a weirdo this Miriam is. When you enter the classroom, you can see your two rivals, Ashley and Wanwan, are doing something bad. By the way, they're hiding. You know it must be really bad. Like counterfeiting recipes bad. Experimenting with restricted ingredients bad. Summoning a demon bad. You try and get a peek over Wanwan's hulking shoulder. But he sees you coming. Woo there, little one. I'm not sure you're ready to handle this. Why don't you make like a bee and mind your own wax, honey? Tell them to stop acting immature. Act like you're not interested in them, but really try and get a closer look. Okay. This is what I do always to them, basically. But if I do this, I will get something to my face or something. I guess we go with this. You sit near the rivals but leave your back turned to them. You even hear Wanwan mutter something that sounds a bit like a magic spell. However, he notices you eavesdropping. You try and cover your tracks and improvise an excuse. It's time for class and you're distracting the rest of us who want to learn. Now you've upset them.
Oh, and you're the emperor of cooking, are you? You make the rules.
I'm not sorry you'd know a good meal if it ate you.
Being the best chef in the world takes more than just culinary skills. It takes creativity. It takes panache.
And it doesn't hurt to use a little evil.
So what are you, Dio, then?
You finally get a look at what it was they were hiding and you instantly recognize it.
It's a book just like the one you found after your encounter with the spork monster.
That's the same book that I found last night in the quad.
Ashley immediately elbows Wan-Wan, who hides the book behind his back.
I don't know what you're talking about. That book is a family heirloom and its contents are secret.
You notice that they haven't just been studying the book. They have got Bob pinned to the wall and they're tossing potato skins at him as he tries to catch them in his mouth.
We are playing!
Before you can dig in any further, you're interrupted by the arrival of more students. It's almost time for class.
Beep beep.
Clank must be running late. He's in such a hurry that he rolls over right over Wan-Wan's meaty foot.
Hey, what's it? Your pocket of balls.
You watch how you talk to him. He didn't do anything.
Who do you think you're talking to? I've never heard such language, not even from a stand mixer.
Womp womp. No, your mother was a stand mixer.
Bzz, bzz. Wan-Wan jumps to attack Clank, but Clank shocks Wan-Wan, sending him flying across the room.
Protect me, Colonel Sanders. These crazed men are about to come to blows. I think it must be over me. But I'm not interested in either of them.
Ashley's tone has completely changed in an instant. She bats her eyelashes at Colonel Sanders. Surely he must know that this is a ruse, right?
Gentlemen, get a hold of yourself. Save it for the arena at least. Or don't. Honestly, what do I care? I've got lofty career aspirations to focus on.
Maybe I can help you with your business plan.
Just then Sprinkles arrives to signal the true start of the class day. He's panting, which doesn't seem that abnormal. He's a professor, but he's also a dog.
Students, students, please take your seats. I apologize for my late arrival. I spent the morning chasing a car all around town and my tiny legs are very, very tired. But I'm here now and I hope you're ready to learn.
Rub his furry dog belly. He loves it. After he catches his breath, Sprinkles regains control of the classroom.
Without further ado, we'll review the global history of my favorite fowl, the chicken.
You want to pay attention to the lesson, truly, you do.
Which is why in 1776, at the signing of the Declaration of Independence, it was a chicken who first signed their name.
But you can't help but daydream about Colonel Sanders and you miss most of the important parts. Yeah, what can I say? My heart is gone. When you come to, Sprinkles is holding a tray of food in front of you.
Well, Sanotsu?
Naturally, this appears to you to be a sample platter. Which item do you want to sample? A glass of water? A shimmering pepper? A dog biscuit? A brightly colored pepper stands out from the other items. It sparkles in a most eye-catching way. So naturally you reach out, grab it and eat it right away.
However, your body is not prepared for the heat.
The pepper has triggered an intense spice hallucination. It feels like forever as you trip through the universe.
My friend, oh.
This guy again.
I'm here to give you an important message, oh. You must avenge my death and fulfill your destiny. All you must do is... I was saying, to fulfill your destiny, all you must do is...
Sorry, I think I've still got some spice stuck in my throat.
It's fine, I'll work through. To fulfill... the prophecy! You must.
You feel yourself begin to regain consciousness.
Oh, man.
You come to and find everyone is staring at you. That pepper was the last of its kind on Earth, and now it's gone forever. You think to yourself, geez, I should pay attention. Better attention.
We all make mistakes, I'm sure he'll forgive you. Someday. Come on, it's time for lunch.
Before anyone can relax, the cafeteria lights dim. And your rivals enter to make a dramatic announcement. Today's lunch will be prepared via timed competitive cook-off. The level of theatrics with these two is off the charts. Demand that they stop wasting everyone's time. Step up and tell them you're on. Here's the thing, they got the freaking book. And they got new things from the book. But I guess I'm on. A bit of lunchtime competition, eh? Can't mean if I have to wipe the tables with you fools before I set my lunch down on it, then so be it. I'm not the fool, you're the fool! Fool!
Good one, one. I like your gumption, Sanotsu. I'll be watching your performance.
Just as things reach a boiling point, Sprinkle steps in. Surely he'll put a stop to this madness.
Now, students, please settle down. This is a lunchroom, not a sporting court.
Finally, a little sense, you breathe a sigh of relief.
At least not until we turn on the timer.
Just then a huge light blasts you in the face, flashing the words, timer ready.
That's what I'm talking about!
Freaky dog. I stand corrected.
The heart way builds solidly a foundation of confidence that cannot be swept away. And that's an original cured by me. In case anyone was wondering, I hope its message lifts you to victory.
Like a diamond, I was formed under pressure, and now is my chance to shine. I will defeat you myself.
You had his chicken and you made mashed potatoes and gravy on day one, and you're feeling like you can really impress him again here. Well, here's the thing. No, you're getting too cocky here, probably. You can't. It's time to boil some water for the potatoes. Think fast, is that if the timer runs down, you'll be forced to pick randomly. What temperature does water boil? That's right, but how would you have even gotten into this school without knowing that? Winner gets to rub my furry belly, let that enticing offer motivate you. Yeah, here's the thing. I'm not much of a dog person. And sure, I'll rub your furry belly if that's like what you really want, teacher, but that's not what motivates me. No. You're going to need to season this chicken before you cook it. You don't know Colonel Sanders' recipe exactly, but you have an idea. How many herbs? That's right, you might not know all the ingredients yet, but at least you're headed in the right direction. Tailbacking intensifies. Now that you've got some basic steps going, it's time to elevate your craft. What state of mind offers the most flavor? Gratitude. That's right. You must never take this opportunity for granted if you hope to succeed. Your classmates are rooting for you, but Ashley is simply stronger and faster than you. You'd better pick up the pace if you want to survive. When you were a child, your father told you to never forget where you came from. Every day, you meditate on his advice and draw energy from that place. Now would be a great time to harness that energy, so where does it come from? Small town, Orion, deep in it. Fuck! Yes. You try to shut out the noise of the arena and focus on your cooking. What's the sound of success? Sizzling. That's wrong. Don't make it get a spray bottle. Next question.
I believe in you, Sanotsu.
He's actually cheering on you. Which would be awesome, except knowing he's watching you makes you totally forget what you were doing. Or said, now all you can think about is Colonel Sanders. Oh god, I know, right? Oh no. How did this come to this?
I've been in this situation younger, when I was younger. Yeah, it happens. When you have a crush, you tend to have some moments that you just can't think of anyone else but them. And it's like, shit, I should be doing some stuff. And I'm like, oh, but he's so cautious. Shit.
Yikes.
I know you love nothing more than seeing a fellow appliance utilized in a kitchen bottle, but sometimes that means sacrificing the personal touch.
You might not have any hands, but Snatcher does. And a good chef needs to be touching the dough to know when it's properly mixed.
There's an easy way and a hard way. You don't get far by going the easy way. When you hear everyone talking, you realize how serious your error was. You immediately shove your hand in the mixer to rescue your dough before it's overmixed.
Sad to know!
But you're not fast enough and your hand gets stuck. It's immediately crushed by the quickly spinning beaters. There's no way you'll be able to use that hand for the rest of the match. Colonel Sanders shakes his head in shame. What you often find is that the easy way can turn out much, much more difficult. Everyone stop what you're doing right now. This battle is over.
It can't be. I was so close to finishing my dish.
Sweetheart, look at your hand. You simply can't go on.
That's too bad. And here I am with a completed dish ready to serve. Certainly that makes me the winner by default.
No, it won't be fair to compare the two on account of Sanotsu's injury.
Yeah, our teacher loves me. Take it, bitch. You see Sprinkles begin to lick his doggy chops as he locks onto the dish.
But I suppose you should at least tell us what you prepared.
Well, because I am the sweetest, I skip it straight to dessert. Under this white chocolate dome, you'll find a wide array of delights, taking you on a journey of flavor that tastes as good and tells a story of excellence. I was going to ask Sanotsu to do the honor, but since you're injured, I'm afraid that
Pouring the screamer of delicate hot chocolate sauce might be too difficult.
Colonel Sanders, if you wouldn't mind lending me your strong, steady hand.
Colonel Sanders pours the hot chocolate sauce on top of the dome, causing it to melt away, revealing the ingredients hidden within. Inside, you'll find a delicate fried cheese croquette, a top of a slice of honeycomb, ice cream two ways, tender nougat, and pearls of blueberry galette. Colonel Sanders seems intrigued, but perhaps not impressed, as he dips his finger in the chocolate sauce.
Simplicity isn't your strong suit, is it, Ashley?
Oh, you!
As he places a sauce-covered finger into his lips, Ashley leans over and whispers something into his ear. A dab of sauce sticks to his mustache. Internalize the rage you feel. Put yourself between Colonel Sanders and Ashley. Well, here's the thing, though. In real life also, like, if my crush has... Like, if I know my crush has feelings for someone else, I am not in between their love, you know? That's not how it works. But I guess, do I want to fight this bitch? Yes, I do. But I could also just build up my rage and kill her later. Which one to do? I guess in this situation, I just do this. You reach out of your apron to wipe off the sauce of his glistening face. Colonel Sanders recoils and presses you back.
This corte isn't just a fashion statement, it's also functional. I was saving that flavor for later.
Yeah, well, oopsie, it doesn't matter. Game over! Try again? Give up! Wow, okay, try again.
Oh, what? Wait, does this mean?
No, does this mean?
No, that I have to... Oh, no,
thank God. I was thinking it started like really, like from the very beginning. Okay. Yes, I am on. Why not? The same. Yes, thank you for the hearts. I love you too. Let's see what happens now. Yes, a row. I stand corrected. Blah, blah, blah. Go away, bish. Yes, I did that and this and potato. Yes. Mm-hmm. Okay. 11. Yeah. Gratitude, yes. Yes. Bubbling. That's wrong. Okay, next question. Ah, of course. And this is where everything... Yes! Mm-hmm. This is where it doesn't matter what I pick. Yeah. Okay. It seems this is more... Yeah, blah, blah, blah. Yes. Yes, easy way, blah, blah, blah. So not to know. Yes, my hand. Oh no, it's crossed. What a shame. Yes, I know. Mm. Your rage burns so intensely within your eyes that they burst into flames. The flames cause your eyebrows to catch fire and turn to ash, and they fall off your face, which means people will have a hard time understanding your emotions for the rest of the semester, perhaps forever. Embarrassed and ashamed by your poor performance, not to mention your crispy fried brow, you run for the quad to be alone. The pitiful weather feels like an insult. Inside of you, a storm rages. It's Colonel Sanders. He's probably here to tell you that he and Ashley are in love and have decided to get married. Wow, what is the age of my character here? Am I like freaking 18? And he won't even ask you to cater his wedding because you're a terrible chef and an awful person. You try to hide from him, but he approaches you directly.
I know you're hurting right now. Not just from the devastating loss, but from that run-in with the mixer and that small fire. We should get that checked out.
I'm fine. Can't you just leave me alone? I'm a loser. I'm not fit to fill your fryer. I'll never be a master chef.
Failure is a part of life, not just for you, but for all of us. Do you think I've never failed at anything before?
That's exactly what I think.
Well then, think again. I wasn't always the man you see before you. Enrolled in culinary school, incredibly handsome, successful, motivated. Well, handsome, sure. I was born that way.
Yeah! Shut up, man!
But I've walked other paths and arrived at dead ends. I was passionate about fire.
About life! Oh, but I failed as an obstetrician. I was passionate about justice, but I failed as a lawyer.
I was passionate about livestock, but I even failed as a mule handler. That one was especially humiliating. Mules can be so cruel. I lost my business partner to a gunfight, and I lost my innocence when I picked up a firearm and put a bullet in my rival. He survived for a while anyhow.
I didn't know.
Also, my voice is going bonkers. I can't no more do these voices properly, but I'm gonna finish this video, so let's just continue. People see my delicate ribbon tie and my well-kept beard and assume that I've got it all together. Which is true now, but it hasn't always been.
Sounds like this guy could really use a hug.
I resolved when that I was going to amount to something. No amount of hours, labor or money would deter me from giving the best I had to give. As Colonel Sanders changed focus, you can see something ignite inside of him, a burning passion. One has to remember that every failure can be a stepping stone to something better. My new dream is pure. It's honest. It's something that a humble man in a crisp white suit can be proud of. I will create a new chain of chicken restaurants that will bring joy to the entire world and make up for my past misdeeds.
Yay!
Just as your moment grows intimate, you're interrupted by a threatening, shadowy presence. Battle scarred from the night before, you prepare for the worst. It's the Spark Monster.
Porco? It is I, and I said I wouldn't be back. And after the whole fight to the death thing, maybe you don't really want to see me anymore, but I just want to say that I was wrong to attack you, and I apologize. I know what it's like having to always look over your shoulder. Monster problems, am I right?
Thanks, Pork. I'm glad there are no hard feelings. Getting jumped by a giant creature in the dark of night can really rile a person up. I also want to apologize for the way I switched right into attack mode.
I know that you're strong and cooking school can put a person under a lot of stress. I actually used to go to school,
I wasn't always a spark monster, you see.
I don't believe it. You were human once?
Well, no, I was a golden retriever. But I was still a student. Until one day some mean kids with a magic spellbook cast a dark enchantment on me. And I was forever transformed.
Oh, jeez, he was a dog. Okay. A magic spellbook?
Precisely. I had procured a copy for myself, but somewhere along the way I've lost it. If you find such a book, I beg of you, respect it.
Respect it?
You're a powerful chef and shouldn't rely on such dark and evil magic. No, you should be protecting the innocent from those who would cheat them through sorcery and guile. If you need me, don't fear, I will be there.
It sounds like there are some bad cooks in the kitchen of life. Sanotsu, together I'm sure we can defeat them. Come back to my hideaway and we can discuss.
A personal invite? You can't imagine what Colonel Sanders' home must be like, but it sounds like you're about to find out. Stepping inside Sanders' home, surrounded by his things, you start to feel a special bond with him. Yes, exactly. This is a bond of friendship, and I shouldn't be this excited.
It looks like you live such an exciting life.
Colonel Sanders, and please forgive me for using your own voice for this. I'm just nervous. Sorry. Oof.
Every day can be an adventure if you approach it with the right attitude. Long ago I made the decision to never stop searching, never stop working, and never stop imagining. Have you been working on any new recipes of your own lately? I'm always excited to talk about food with another ambitious chef.
Okay, yeah. This is the point where my character should realize he's not necessarily trying to find romantic partner here. He wants a fellow chef who shares same kind of dreams with him and, you know, wants to be successful with him or without him, who cares? Well, there is something, it's just a side dish that I've been tinkering with, trying to find the right balance of flavors and textures. I'm not sure I've nailed it yet, but I'm close.
Colonel Sanders' eyes perk up as he starts to wonder what this you might be describing.
Wait, what? Hmm? It's meant to pair with something spicy or something crispy, bold, perhaps? Now you got him right where you want him. Should you reveal your new creation to him or keep it a secret just for you? Okay, let's be honest. He was revealing things to me and he's been good to me and I've been good to him. Bonk, reveal it. You decide that you're as ready as you'll ever be to share your original cooking with Colonel Sanders. Before you can talk yourself out of it, you decide to dive in headfirst. You reach into your lunch bag for a special dish that you've been keeping on ice all day. I present to you my original coleslaw. The shredded cabbage dish glistens in the light of Colonel Sanders' luxe hideaway.
Magnificent!
Together you chow down on the creamy slaw until just a spoonful remains in the bowl.
Do you mind if I hold on to the last bite? I'd like to have it around so that I can admire it days later and think back on this moment.
You could offer to make him more, but he seems like a very sentimental kind of guy. Sure, why not?
Please make yourself comfortable. I'll be back in just a moment.
You realize that now would be the perfect time to do some snooping. Around the room are various items that you can look closer at. Each item seems to radiate memories and emotions. tap on an item to discover more about the colonel. You take a closer look at a large urn. Plague on it, it's dusty. Here lies the ashes of all my past careers and business failures. Oh goodness. Poor guy. Can chicken be prepared sashimi style? If you ask Japanese people, they have already done it, so yes. Yeah. Yep. Oh no. Okay. You know, this is very realistic stuff, a chicken sitting on a corner table. When you pick it up, you realize it isn't just realistic, it's real. Taxidermy. Must have been important to Colonel Sanders when it was alive. A little note clipped to the chicken's foot reads, the true state bird of the great state of Kentucky. Tap on an item to discover more about. Okay, so. Lock of silver hair is woven through the teeth of the comb. Oh no, don't be creep. Upon further inspection, you realize that the hair there isn't just silvery in color, it's actually made of spun silver. Okay. A scented candle, you pick it up and try to identify the smell. Power tool? Freshly starched collar? Piece of wood floating in a lake? Summer of 69? No, it's one of the secret recipe ingredients. It's... Oh fuck. It's the salt. Tap on an item to discover more about the colonel. The photo appears to be Colonel Sanders, except he's an old man visiting the pyramids of Egypt. Maybe this is where he discovered one of his secret herbs and spices. One of the framed photos shows an old man who looks a bit like Colonel Sanders standing with a friend. They hold fried chicken drumsticks and appear to be searing them. My friend Pete. Yes, nice view. Just then a ghost of student pops up.
What are you thinking about hitting out in the world on a quest to avenge my dad?
Wait, what? I never even learned your name. Why would I avenge you?
I could just tell you my name right now. It's...
Can't you see I'm in the middle of something? Okay, that's... That's rude. Of me. Feels bad. You open the window, a crack, and the ghost of student is swept out with a breeze. You open the door, the colonel center's closed, and find the rope of his signature white suit hanging with. You take one of its hanger and try it on. The jacket is a bit big for you, but it's soft and comfortable. Okay, I don't know how big this guy really is in real life and if he is alive anymore. But I am... God dang it. I'm not a small woman, so... La. Before you can look any further, you hear Colonel Sanders returning. He has a new dish that he has been working on and he wants you to taste it. You try to act casual until he asks you why you are wearing his jacket. Because I'm a creep.
I don't usually loan those out, but I must say it does look good on you.
Ah, thanks, man. Oh crap, the jacket. You forgot to take it off. You fess up and tell the truth. You confess. I think I've developed feelings for you.
I might be developing feelings for you too, but I'm concerned. I can't let anything get in the way of my dreams.
Yeah, I see how it is. Overwhelmed, you take off the jacket and run for the door. But the thought of leaving Colin in the midst of such an emotional breakthrough gives you pause. You stop yourself. Colonel?
Yes, Sanatsu.
I honestly think this may be the beginning of something wonderful. I think you're right.
We should take things slow.
You talk late into the night and drift off into a slumber. Dream sequence! You awake to a beautiful morning in Colonel Sanders' hideaway. Did you make the right decision on how to respond to Colonel Sanders? Only time will truly tell. Today is a day that could change the rest of your life. You think about the new secret ingredient that you just learned about. No, don't think of it. No, no, no. Don't do it. In some jurisdictions, isn't even legal, but if the recipe is a secret, how will... Wait, is it MSG? Oh, God. Your thoughts are interrupted when Colonel Sanders emerges into the room. He's holding a gorgeously prepared breakfast and your mouth waters at the side of it.
Here's a simple breakfast I just whipped up.
It's meticulous. Oh, is that biscuits, butter and drumstick? To tell you the truth, I have never eaten biscuit. Yeah, that's not an surprise because I don't live in America or in... you know, in England. Okay. You taste Colonel Sanders' food and it takes you on a journey. When you return, he's waiting to ask you an important question.
So, would you say that we are the perfect match?
How presumptuous.
My cuisine and your taste buds, that is.
Such confidence, such grace, could he be the world's greatest gift to cookery? Okay, like, in real life. In my country, we are getting our first Kentucky Fried Chicken in this year. So I have never eaten Kentucky Fried Chicken or from this franchise, from this man. So, I guess I'll flatter him just because this is a game. I guess it's good, I don't know. You know, I think we might make a great team.
A single tear begins to pool in the corner of his eye as he gazes out the window.
And with the right business partner, I know I can't fail.
Business partner? Could he be talking to you? It's all happening so quickly. Now! God dang it.
Overcome with emotion and confused by your feelings, you're on the verge of tears, unable to speak. The only answer you can find is to run out of the door and get home. There's still one more day of school after all. The University of Cooking School Academy for Learning waits for no one.
Okay, this has been it for this time of since my voice. I don't know what's going on anymore. This has been Snotsu. Bye bye.